Hey guys, so today's video is going to be my January favorites. I don't have a lot of stuff. I don't really have a lot of stuff to talk about this month, oddly enough, but I feel really gothic. I was just like playing around with makeup today before I started filming, and then this happened. It's intense, I know. Okay, so the first thing I want to talk about is actually my lip color, but not specifically my lip color, just a brand of lipstick. These are the NYX matte lipsticks. I discovered these really early on in the month and I purchased a bunch of them. The first one I ever purchased was this one right here called Spirit. And it's such a really pretty, like, everyday color. I used it a bunch of times throughout the month. And I love the formula so much that I went and bought like 5 more of these matte lipsticks. I get mine at Ulta.com. They do have them at Ulta, and I think I've seen some at Target, but I just ordered them online. And they're actually really, really good. They're really inexpensive, and they feel nice on the lips. They don't settle into my lines, and they are a nice matte formula, but they aren't drying. I don't know, I like them a lot. So I really have been loving this one, which is the one I'm wearing on my lips. I'm into brown lipstick. That's just my thing right now, is really dark brown lipstick. So that's this one, it's called Mason. It's a nice, nice, dark, dark, vampy color. And then of course, Spirit. And then I really also love this one in Euro Trash. That name is so weird. But it's a nice, deeper, neutral color. I really, really love them. Like I said, what I like most about these are the formula. I am very into matte lips these days, like hardcore. Okay, so my next favorite is something I didn't think I would love as much as I do, and it is the Anastasia Contour Kit. I say Anastasia. So at first I didn't think I was gonna like it at all, because I was like, I'm not gonna get use out of most of these shades. I'm only gonna use like 1 or 2 colors. But no, I use actually quite a few colors. I use this one to contour. This is Fawn, and it is the color I have on today to contour my cheeks. And then after I contour, sometimes I'll take this one right here called Java, and I'll just dust a little bit around my temples and just give a little bit of warmth. The only color that I really don't use at all is this one, because it's too dark for my skin tone. But when I'm self-tanning, I'm not self-tanning right now, but when I'm self-tanning, I can get away with it a little bit. But I love these two shades. This one is Banana, and I'm not sure what this one's called, but I like to set my under eye concealer with this and then go over it with this color, because I don't like too yellow. I don't like products that are too yellow under my eyes, so I always go over it with this one, and I find that this really brightens my under eye area a lot. So the only color that I really despised in this was the color that was right here. I took it out. It was supposed to be like a highlight shade, but it barely had any shimmer. It was like a really dull, like, highlight shade. I didn't like it at all for my cheekbones. I like something a little bit more intense to highlight. So I actually popped it out and then popped in a Makeup Forever eyeshadow, one of their artist eyeshadows. The Makeup Forever eyeshadows are a little bit bigger than this, so I had to like squish it in there. I had to like force it in there. But I did that because I really liked this color to highlight. This is a Makeup Forever eyeshadow, like I just said. But I actually really like this color on my cheekbones because it's super intense. So I just popped it in here, and this is my little contour kit. I took this with me to California, and this is the only thing I used on my cheeks to contour, to bronze a little bit, and to highlight my cheeks. Like, this is the only thing I used. This is the original one. Now they have a bunch of different colors. You can customize your own, and they're refillable, so you can pop these out if you hit pan and buy some more. So I really, really love this a lot more than I thought I would. Okay, so surprisingly enough, I have been using this little trio from e.l.f. a lot this month. This is like their new, I'm pretty sure this is new. They actually sent this to me with like 3 other ones. And you guys know how much I love their baked eyeshadows. I have purchased all of them. And now they have like baked trios, which is so cool. So I love this one the most. This is in the shade Brown Bonanza. I love it. I used this gold color all over my lid a lot, and then I just put the darker brown like a little bit in the outer V, and it makes a whole look. I do need like a matte crease color and a highlight shade and all that stuff, but these two eyeshadows are beautiful and so pigmented. They're gorgeous. I love really golden eye looks, and I actually really love this trio in Brown Bonanza. It's beautiful. Okay, so my go-to lip liner this month was MAC's etc. lip liner. This is their Pro Longwear lip pencil. These are my favorite lip liners ever. It reminds me a lot of my Too Faced Perfect lip liner, which is my favorite lip liner. The Pro Longwear lip liners, okay, how many times can I say lip liner? The Pro Longwear lip pencils are the best at MAC. I really love their original too, like their normal lip pencils, but their Pro Longwear ones are amazing because they do not budge and they're so creamy that they don't skip on your lip, on your lips. And I love this shade. It's a really, really warm, neutral, like peachy brown. You know, like an everyday lip liner. I wore this almost every day when I was in California, and it's just the best. I wore it like crazy this month. I wore it yesterday. It's like, it's good stuff. It's starting to look a little dingy. I've like sharpened it a million times already because I cannot put this down. So it is a very matte finish, and whenever I want this color, but I want it to be a little bit glossy, I put on this lipstick. CoverGirl came out with a bunch of new lipsticks. I don't even know what they're called, but this one is my favorite. I actually have another one, a pink one, that I don't really like that much. It's okay, but this one is beautiful. This is in 255 Tempting Toffee. I love this lip combo. It's like the most beautiful peachy brown lip combo ever. I actually had this lip combo on in that New Year's Eve makeup tutorial that I did with the blue eyes and like the gold eyeliner. This is the lip combo I was wearing, and I love it. Okay, and then my last beauty favorite is actually something that I want to mention because I have been using it a lot this month. A lot in combination with this, but I have been using my Wet n Wild Vanity Palette like crazy. I got this like a year and a half ago, and I bought it on Amazon because this was discontinued like a while ago. And I don't know why, because it's honestly like the best drugstore eye palette in the history of the world. It's like the best palette I have ever come across, and I wanted to mention it just in case you guys see this on Amazon or eBay. Definitely pick it up. I paid like $10 for it. It wasn't that price when it was being sold, but I paid like $10 for it because it's so good. This color right here, these two colors are amazing matte colors. They aren't chalky at all. They're beautiful. And this bronzy shade right here, I mean, every color in this palette is absolutely wonderful. The only color that they sell individually now is this one right here, and it's called Brulee. They sell it in their regular like $1 eyeshadows. But seriously, if you see Vanity somewhere online, I seriously recommend picking it up. I have been using this brown like in my crease like every day this month. I just recently picked it up again. It's been sitting in my makeup collection. I haven't touched it, but recently it's been my go-to. Okay, and then two more products that aren't beauty related. This is the Dr. Teal's Pure Epsom Salt Foaming Bath. This is a soothe and sleep with lavender. Lavender is like one of my all-time favorite scents, as you guys already know. I've said that about a million times. But this is like the best bubble bath I have ever used, ever. It gets really, really like soapy and bubbly in the shower, and it smells amazing, like lavender and Epsom salt. It has like that minty, really like spa like scent. Oh, it smells like it's powerful in my nose, but it really does relax you. Like, I put this in my bathtub and I just lay back, and it's like the mintiness and the lavender, just it puts me in a nice relaxing mood. And this was so cheap. I think this cost like $7 at Ulta. I ordered it on ulta.com. so inexpensive, and it's like a huge tub. It's really big. I highly recommend it if you are into like Epsom salt and lavender. Put this in your bath. You will not be disappointed. And then my last favorite is really, really exciting. So, okay, I like stalk Jaclyn Hill. Like, I've mentioned her in my like past five videos. It's kind of embarrassing, but I like stalk Jaclyn Hill, and I was watching her December favorites, I believe it was, and she was talking about this brand. This is the Blissful Body. She was actually talking about this, I believe. This is the Blissful Body Luxury Skincare Made by Hand Body Butter. And she was talking about how it's the best body butter in the history of the world. And I was like, wow, I really need to get my hands on that. And then like a couple of weeks later, this was in my P.O. box. The woman has an Etsy shop. I will link, whoa. The woman has an Etsy shop. Her name is Casey or Cassie. I'm not sure because I can't pronounce anything. I will link her Etsy shop down below. But I guess she watched my videos and she liked my videos that she sent me these in my P.O. box. And I was like, oh my God, wait a minute. This is the stuff that Jaclyn Hill was raving about, so I was really excited to try this. Guys, Jaclyn Hill was not kidding. This body butter is real. It's like intense, it's thick, it's so hydrating, but it's like, I don't know if you could tell, it's so thick. It doesn't even feel like liquidy at all. It's, oh my god. And this is in the like scent buttercream, amazing. But I have to say that the standout product for me is this guy right here. This is the Blissful Body Hand and Body Lotion in Lemon Buttercream. Lemon is like my favorite scent ever, and it's so good. This obviously isn't a body butter, it's more like a lotion. So it's a little bit less hydrating, but I love it like for every day. I have been like rubbing my hands in this every single day, like every 10 minutes I'm like putting lemon buttercream all over. You smell like a real, like this smells like real, not artificial at all. Like nothing fake, I swear. It's like I rubbed a little lemon loaf all over my body in a not disgusting way. So these products are super hydrating. I will definitely leave her information down below so you can check out her Etsy shop. I'm actually gonna be filming a video about my favorite Etsy shops soon, because I have been like Etsy crazy recently and I have been discovering really amazing like little businesses. So I wanna do a video dedicated to like nice Etsy shops. My Cornelius, look, it's Cornelius, my favorite dog. Don't tell the rest of them, don't tell the rest of them. Okay guys, so those were my favorites. These were the standout products for me this month. I know it wasn't a lot of products, but I love everything that I talked about like dearly. Another thing I wanna mention, I will be doing a drugstore haul soon. I know that recently I have been buying a lot of high-end makeup, and whenever I've been doing a haul, it's been high-end. And I always used to say that whenever I did a high-end haul, I always wanted to follow up with a drugstore haul just to keep it even on my channel, because I know some people love drugstores, some people love high-end. But I just wanted to tell you this because I don't want you guys to think that I'm all about high-end now, because I will be posting a high-end haul, like my LA haul that you guys wanted to see very soon, like the California shopping I did at Sephora and Macy's and stuff. And it was like epic, like very high end, and you know, I was celebrating my birthday and hitting 500,000, so I just went balls out. But I will continue to do drugstore on my channel. I just wanna make that very clear. It will always be that way. Even no matter how many subscribers I have, I will always keep it, I will always balance it out. You guys know I do like a lot of drugstore looks, like full face drugstore looks. And recently the drugstore came out with a bunch of new stuff. My Walgreens and Target, you know, they're always like last to get things. But I will be doing a drugstore haul soon and playing around with new drugstore makeup, like spring collections and stuff that they're coming out with that I'm gonna go buy and look at. I just wanna make that clear that no matter how many subscribers I get, no matter what, that I will always do drugstore looks and buy drugstore makeup and include drugstore products. You guys are the reason I have gotten this far, so I will always do drugstore for you. So I just wanted to mention that. Sorry if throughout this whole video I'm like a little bit like, I don't know, I feel like really strange, like down in the dumps. I don't know why, I just really do. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so much. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Oh, and leave me a comment down below your all-time favorite product for the month of January, and then I will check it out, like your ultimate favorite beauty product. What has saved your skin this month? Your lips this month? What is the color? What is your favorite lipstick this month? I don't know. Okay, I'm leaving now. Thank you for watching. I've said that already. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.